Hey you guys, welcome to Living It Country. Today we have another beautiful farmhouse styled home to tour for the Christmas 2020 season, and I am so excited to be sharing my friend Jessica Giffen. She has a beautiful YouTube channel filled with home decor inspiration, DIY projects, and motivation to make your house absolutely beautiful. I will have her link to her YouTube channel in the description box down below. So without further ado, let's get started.
So we have a sleepy pup right here by the door, and this is my little entryway area that I did. I was so inspired by this reindeer farm sign that I picked up this year at Hobby Lobby, and so I kind of just set a scene around it, and this is one of my favorite areas to just kind of decorate and go all out with for each season. So yeah, this is the entryway. And I love it. I love that it just gives me all of the farmhouse Christmas vibes right when you walk in. And I forgot, I'm just noticing, to turn on these lights. I love them so much. These are the snow globe lights. You may have seen them at the Target dollar spot, but they also have them at Hobby Lobby if you were not able to find them. Okay, so I just turned them on. I have two strings up on mine, and they just have little battery packs, which is nice, so you don't have to plug them in. And actually, Jen from Cook, Clean, and Repeat, who is a part of this home tour, she is the one who let me know that they had these at Hobby Lobby, so shout out to her. Hey, Jen. And yeah, these are just one of my favorite new finds this season. And as I've mentioned in my other videos, I love mixing in new items as well as vintage pieces. Like that sleigh I picked up was a vintage find, and I just love it. I mixed in some of my silver items. Oh, I was asked a few questions about this reindeer farm bag, and I actually got that at Vintage Market Days. They have them, I don't know, in different places, and they have a lot of vendors that come in. So unfortunately, I can't link that one. And then directly across from the entryway is this little room where I kind of edit my videos, so I call it my office, and it's also where we do crafts and stuff and hang out with the kids during the day. We do have toys and stuff over here. And this big cabinet I get a lot of questions on. I found this at Hobby Lobby, and this is just great. We organize all of our crafting supplies and like books and school books and stuff in there. So I didn't go too crazy with the decor in here, even though I loved being able to put up this tree. This is the other one that Balsam Hill sent me from a comparable big box store, and it's honestly great. I don't know if I'm gonna decorate it, but I like having a tree by the window, so when you pull into our house, you can see it all lit up. I don't know, I think there's something so magical about that. And then I hung up with hooks these almost like a paper cardboard material stars that I found at IKEA this year. And then I threw one on top of the tree as well, but I like to just dress up this wall and this sign for each season. But I like that these stars were a little bit different, but they also wouldn't get in our way because sometimes decor can do that. So I just kept these shelves really simple over here, just on the corner piece. And then that's kind of messy, but that's just real life. That's their games and books and things like that. One of my new ads over here was from last year. This was a Christmas DIY, our Christmas bucket list. And I will link that video down below if you want to see exactly how I made it, but it was so easy. This is just that brown craft paper, and I basically just traced this on. And I thought it would be fun to put here over the kids' table. and that chalkboard over there falls down all of the time, so I really need to figure out something with that. But let's keep on walking into our house. And this is our other dog, Aspen. So you will usually see them napping in the background of all of my videos. And over here, I put up garland last night, and I decided to mix two of the pieces that I picked up this year. Both are from Walmart, and actually the flocked one I picked up last year, but this one, I believe this was called the natural garland. This was from Walmart as well, and I just layered them on top of each other because I felt like one just wasn't full enough, and I kind of like the effect and look that it gives. And I also wanted to show you these. This is what I hung it with, and they just basically clip over the garland onto the railing, and they're such a lifesaver. I found those at Walmart as well. And then over here is our living room. I always feel like I have a lot of decor going on, but to me it doesn't seem too overwhelming because I usually go with a lot of neutral colors. So over here on this table, I just have a couple candlesticks and then my little DIY threshold tree. I made this using two of the trees from the Target Dollar Spot, and I basically tied them together, and it just kind of made them a little taller, made it look a little bit nicer and high end. So that was a good $10 dupe for the $25 threshold tree. So if you're not following me on Instagram, I share a lot of DIYs over there, including this one, and it's saved to my Christmas 2020 highlight. So I will leave my handle here if you want to go check that out. Over here, I just put some pillows, this really cozy throw blanket, which I found at Walmart last year, and it was so cheap. I think it was only like $15, I want to say. And then this sign, which I got last year from Kirkland's, and I know a lot of other people picked it up this year as well. It's huge, it's beautiful. That's my favorite Christmas book. So nice. Here are the shelves. I just switched them out for some Christmassy items. And here is my fireplace area. I added the stockings. We have the ones from Target. We've had them for years now, and I don't know, I just don't have the heart to change them out. I love them so much, and I picked up Hunter hers, so really cute. This is my Balsam Hill garland. I think it's called the Harvest Garland, but again, I will link it down below. And their pine needles are just the most realistic, and it lights up, which is great. Also using a battery pack, which is really handy. And I also shared on my Instagram how I made this really simple stocking swag just using leftover pieces of garland. You can even cut off some small pieces if you wanted to, and I just thought it was cute, and it came together in maybe like 2 minutes. It was so easy to make. And yeah, I just thought this garland added some nice, or a nice pop of color to this area, since I do decorate with a lot of neutrals. And not to sound like a broken record, but these gold dipped logs, I also shared on my Instagram how I made those. I got this idea from Anthropology. They had something just like this set up in one of their displays, and I just thought it was so fun for Christmas. So this fireplace is not real. It's a completely faux built out fireplace. I did the faux brick on the inside to make it realistic, so I just bought some logs from my grocery store. I will link my Instagram if you want to see how I did this. I'm not going to get into it in this video, but it's saved to my Christmas 2020 highlight as well. And then over here, this is my new Balsam Hill tree. I love it. This is the Brewer Spruce, and I don't have the actual lights on because my camera's doing something a little funky, and it kind of makes them look like they're blinking. So anyway, long story short, I have an entire video on this tree and all of the decorations on here. How fun are these little candle clips? They're so cute. So I will have that linked in my Christmas playlist down below if you want the details on this tree. And then look at this beautiful tree skirt and tree collar. I love villages and houses, especially for Christmas, so I just love that. And this is a faux fur which I got in white because it kind of reminded me of snow for the little tree collar village. So fun. First year I decorated with ribbon and I love it. I like to keep my decor pretty minimal, but I think this turned out really well. And still, you know, it's neutral, so it's not overwhelming me. And of course, I have to mention this. I got so many questions on it. So it's actually not a picture. This is a TV. It's called the Samsung Frame TV. And I just downloaded this picture off of the internet and I saved it. Kind of like you can set a background for your phone, you can set a background for your TV. So the Frame TV, when it's off, it's made to look like a picture. So the background that you set is what shows up when your TV's off. And then I'm not gonna lie, these pillows never look like this, but I just set them up for this video. We use this couch all of the time, but this one is one of my favorites. It's another thing that I got from Vintage Market Days. I love the grain sack pillows. They're so cute. And then this is my little vintage table over here set up. So I just stacked a tree in two crates, and then I also put some of this, a couple of these logs over here as well, just so this table didn't look so thin against the wall. I wanted to add some decor on either side. And then this is a really pretty mantle village from Balsam Hill. When I get closer, you can see that I have it elevated on a bowl, because when you are back here, it's raised up and you're able to see it properly, but you can obviously see the bowl if you're standing right here. But anyway, this is that village and I just think it's so pretty. And I just have two trees from Hobby Lobby and some more vintage decor, this really beautiful sign from Kirkland's. I love the chalkboard style signs. So that is that little table, which I love to decorate seasonally as well. And then moving into the dining room and kitchen area, some new additions over here are these pine wreaths that I found at Hobby Lobby. I think they were like $7 marked half off. And I like to just add some seasonal wreaths to these chairs. And I also get a lot of questions on these chairs. They are from World Market and all of their furniture is marked 30% off right now. So I will link those down below if you're interested. And one of the things that you guys loved the most is this little section. It's honestly my favorite part of my kitchen, I wanna say, and especially my favorite style that I've decorated this ladder since I got it. This ladder is from Kirkland's as well, and I think it's just perfect for a kitchen. You can hang your mugs on it. And this year I hung a lot of my seasonal hand towels and things like that. I've been really into collecting the vintage Santa mugs, so that's fun. I also mentioned that I love decorating with ornaments, not necessarily just on a tree, so I incorporated some of those to this space as well. And then my scale, I just kind of set a wreath in there and put a lantern in it, so I thought that looked pretty cute. And then if you go around here, I like to switch up my peg rail for each season as well, so kept it pretty simple with just a simple wreath. And then this basket I always have up there, I just put a little Target dollar spot tree. And then this tree, the tree itself I believe was from TJ Maxx, but I love adding these dried orange slice ornaments on there. I think it's perfect if you want to have like a little kitchen tree. So a lot of you asked for a tutorial, which again, I plan on doing on my Instagram. So follow me over there. It's easier for me to share quick little tutorials in that space than over here. So if you walk into the kitchen, I have my KitchenAid over here, and this was fun. Miles and I were looking at our Christmas cookie cutters, which I'm just keeping in here for now. So something new that I did is I put my mixing bowl on this big Hearth and Hand tray, and I just thought it kind of grounded it and gave it a cool look. I also mixed in some vintage rolling pins, the red and the green for Christmas. I have my radon canister and a little bottle brush tree. I don't use my KitchenAid all that much, to be honest, so this works for me, but if you use yours a lot, I could see why this setup might not be functional. Oh, and I also got questions on this bowl. I found this at Ross, but I believe they have some like this on Amazon, so if I can find one, I will link that down below as well, and also links to all of this stuff just in case there's something that you see. Make sure you check down there. You might be able to find a link for it. And then I just set up this wooden tree that I got on clearance at Hobby Lobby because the bottom's broken, but I thought it just kind of looked cute here. And then this pedestal, also hearth in hand, I displayed some of my Christmassy vintage tins. I love collecting vintage tins, except for the tall one. That is from Michael's last year. They always have some like vintage looking tins, which that's fine. I don't have to have things actually vintage, but I just like that look. And over the stove, I hung some copper pots and this really cool Turkish coffee pot, which I did find vintage, along with another little wreath. And on top of my hood range, I got this swag from the Hearth and Hand collection. And I actually just used a little clear push pin to hang it, and it worked perfectly up here, so that was nice. And then down here, I just put a really distressed looking cutting board with my repurposed thrift haul find, and I just used it to put some candles in, but I might use it for florals when we're in a different season. So I love finding things like that that we can repurpose. I also keep this out just for, I don't know, I like the look of all of the copper in my kitchen. I think it just adds a nice cozy feel and brings some warmth in here. And then I also have this little Michael's crate up top with some Walmart trees. I love decorating on top of my fridge. I think it's just a nice little pop of color up there. And again, kind of breaks up some of the white that I have going on. And this is my tiered tray this year. I have a whole video on this, so I won't waste too much time here. Check out that video if you want the details, but I love how everything came together. I got some questions on the houses, and unfortunately, those were Target Dollar Spot last year. So I wish that they brought them back because they're so fun. And the mini Santa espresso mugs are from Hobby Lobby, so those were really cute as well and kind of went with my theme. And then on the back side, I just have some vintage items, this really pretty music paper that I rolled up there. I love using ornaments on my tiered tray. And these little deer were a vintage find. They're made out of little book pages. So cute. And then my really simple tablescape, I'm showing you from this side because the lighting is just terrible with the window in the back, but I did get a couple comments that I need some sort of runner to go here, and I agree, it's a DIY that I have on my list, but I just haven't had a chance to get to it yet. And then I used another one of those really cheap Walmart garlands to go on my light fixture. That's another really fun, unexpected place to add some seasonal decor. And the bottle brush trees are all from Hobby Lobby. This one is just, I don't know, this is definitely a more bottle brush material. This one is almost like a stick material, but the muted colors go really well together, I think. And then over here is our little coffee bar area, and I love switching out the decor on these shelves. For every season, I have my mercantile sign back, which just gives me all the antique vintage feels. And then over here, just a lot of vintage bottle brush tree finds. And I did a little hand-drawn chalkboard sky to go behind these ornaments that they have at Target right now in the, I think it's called the Wonder Shop. And they're $3 a piece, but I thought they were just so cute. So I picked them up and set up a little village on this space. And then my Santa mugs. I love using cloches and putting them over these little house ornaments. I know this is a little close to the edge, but I don't know. I think it'll be okay. And what else? More vintage finds. These hobnail sugar and creamer set. How cute are they? And I actually put some cinnamon sticks in here, and I made this candy cane, I want to say 2 years ago, using Dollar Tree candy canes, and I just took ribbon that I liked and wrapped it around. I love that. It's so cute, I think. And then these Christmas mugs are from Hobby Lobby. This coffee grinder is a vintage find. And then there's a grocery store near me called Publix that had this cute little Santa mug as well. So this is the Publix version and this is the Hobby Lobby one. I think they're both so cute. And for the Santa up here, I put this little hat on him from one of my Ray Dunn mugs that had that hat as a topper, and it's a perfect fit. So if you like the Santa mugs and you have the Ray Dunn hat, that's an option that I think just looks adorable. And then I just mixed in more copper finds, vintage finds, things like that. So yeah, I love how this little section came together this year.